Hello, artist. How are you today? Stephanie Aune coming to you from the banks of the Trinity River here near Willow Creek, California. Oz and I welcome you to the studio. We are very happy you're here with us today. So in this week's edition of Creating Your First Altered Book, we finish up the front cover. So last week we put down these details. I believe it was called white sand, which is a Prima texture paste. And then we made the stencil, and then we put the gold crackle paste in that stencil. I also took that same stencil this week and went through and put a very thick layer of that platinum colored texture paste. And you can get those down in the Amazon links. I then went through and did a bunch of little dots with the Ranger liquid pearls. They really give a gorgeous effect. I have a link for the liquid pearls down in the comments. And if you can use those links, that'd be really awesome. I would really appreciate it. Amazon does give me a little bump if I suggest or recommend a product to you. So thank you very much if you do use them. I do need to give a shout out to my amazing Patreons. And once again, guys, thank you so very much. Without your support, I would not be able to continue to do this. And I would really love to get back to doing art full time. But until I get a few more Patreons, that's not going to happen. So have to pay the bills, have to buy Oz and I some food and pay to have a car. You know, all those fun things that we need money for. If you are able to support the channel, your $10 pledge or your $25 pledge a month really does make a huge difference in my life. And I do greatly appreciate your support. All right. If you jump on over to Patreon, you'll get all the details there. I don't want to go into too much detail with that. So thank you, everybody. You are really awesome. Now, this is our last page on this book. I will be going through and just doing some final touch-ups to see if I need to cover any white spots or anything like that. And we will do our final walkthrough on this book. Ooh, we'll do it next week. Okay, guys, I hope you have a great day, and we'll chat soon. All right, enjoy the video. Bye-bye. All right, we're going to pull out the Lumiere paint, and we are going to go for it. Now, I did put one little squirt of, like, a tangerine. Where's all my paper towels? Distress ink spray in there. Oh, what color do I have in my paintbrush there? That was one that I missed. So of course, since I can never quite leave well enough alone, let's see what happens when we bring some of our Timber Brown stays on over the top. Hi, Oz. Like, who are you talking to? Is it anybody I can play with? I want to play with somebody. Because I'm going crazy. I'm going crazy. What you doing? Where's my ball? Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. Where's my ball at? Oh goodness gracious, Mom. What you doing? Is it fun? Can I do it too? Huh? Can I do it too? Oh my God, I'm so bored even though I've been running all day. Oh. And that's what Ozzy says. Okay, well, we let one thing dry since I have 15 projects that I have to do this week. Let's keep going. All right, let's find our center. That's gonna be our center-ish. Doesn't have to be perfectly exact, but on the other hand, we want it to make sense. We want it to be lined up with the other one. We want it to be in the center of these two things. So, you know, get them to where you can see them. Except. I guess it's just gonna be best to just do it like that. Now, what we don't wanna do is we don't wanna get it into the rays. We don't. And I was gonna grab my little scotch tape. Oh gosh, I have no idea where it is, of course. Because if I could ever find one thing from one day to the next, it would be an amazing miracle. Oh my God. Somebody buy me an organizer person to come and organize all this stuff to make sense so that I can find things. All right, we are grabbing our platinum crackle paste and our synthetic brush, or our silicone brush. I'm putting down big mush pile. And I'm just filling in, trying to fill it in carefully. Now, again, that's a very thick coat of this texture paste. I want to have it super crackle. And those ridges are kind of fun. Those ridges will mellow out. But there we go. There is our moon. It's a little wonky, and that's just fine by me. Oh, that's pretty cool. We're going to leave that just like that. And I think I lined it up pretty well. You know, if you take that 3/4 inch, 3/4 inch. That's even to there and to there. So I did pretty good on that. I'm not going to mess with it too much more. I might put a little bit more right here in the middle. I love how that looks like the crags of the moon, but I think what it's gonna do is flatten out like the other one did. So we'll see what happens with it. Okay, so that was a great way to reuse our homemade stencil that we made last week. And now we need to go wash off all of our stuff and make sure it is nice and clean because, as we know, texture paste will dry like a rock. So I think this will be a great compliment to our sun. Okay, we'll chat soon. I'll bring you back when it's dry. right, artists. What I've just been doing here is just kind of building up the colors. I really like this combination of the purples and the blues and bringing in that gold highlight. I love this color that it kind of creates when that gold is a little bit wet and you bring over those other two colors. It's kind of this real beautiful, misty, shimmery iridescence. Love it. There's really not a whole lot of I'm just using those three colors, so I'm not taking a lot of thought on I can't say I'm not taking a lot of thought on what color combinations are going where. Basically, this purple and blue versus the silvery gold is going to automatically create extra scintillation, meaning that the colors will work well off of each other and make the focal more vibrant. Always trying to get the maximum amount of vibrancy on a page. At least I am. I want my... Well, not usually, not always, but especially in this case, I really do want it to stand out. Move your project to where it is easiest for you to work on here. I'm trying to get it as round as possible here, but some irregularity is going to be expected because of the stencil that I used when I cut it out, and then also it popping up. So this kind of isn't a... I am purposely not making this be a very sterile circle. I want it to feel like it has some dimension to it. I want to feel like it has so much texture in there. I mean, look at how much texture. The deeper I got, the thicker I got, I cannot speak today. The thicker I made the texture paste, the larger the crackles became, which I think is super cool in this moon case. I think that's perfect. Now, I think this Lumiere pearlescent white was a beautiful color to put over the top of this silver. I need to push that out just a little bit more. Right in there. And it's okay if it picks up a little bit of that blue or that purple that we had underneath of there, because then it brings that color in just a touch along the edges, which is going to give us more shading on this. Yes. All right. Now, if I remember right, I think I took my gold alcohol ink and brushed it over the tops of these, which I'll want to go through and do that again. I think this is dry enough to where I can bring in my liquid pearls. Liquid pearls. I just want to see here. Let's see, this is more of a silver one, platinum pearl. That'll be perfect. This is a warmer color. So I want to stay with these same blues that we have. So as much as this did get added in there along the very edge. We'll think about this one. We want to use the colors that we know for sure that we used on the front, on the back. And the reason for that is we want to have it feel the continuity of that. So I'm going to kind of test here and see which color I had. This is the lighter one. So I had this lighter color in the center. I had three rings on this. I don't know if I want to do three rings on this one. So we're going to start with the outer ones. I think it would be good to do three rings just because it would have the same feeling. It would be mimicking the same feeling. All right. That first one was on the very edge. All right. Try to find a support for your pinky. And we're going to try to find the center here, or a good place to start. Okay, so you guys see what I'm doing here? And I'm moving my book. I'm balancing my hand. It helps to steady it. We all know when we've had enough coffee and not enough protein, right? Our hands start to shake. We don't want that to happen. I do remember that I used that lighter green on this outline. I think that would be kind of cool to do. Looks like I also used it a little bit on this inside one. Now, I'm going to evaluate before I add and really look at it and say, okay, do I need those? I think I do. I think I need to add the inner circles. That one's almost out of paint. That's pretty cool. All right. We're going to still take that lighter blue, go around the outer edge. And let's do the darker ring. I'm going to add a ring of silver to this, maybe. Maybe. The silver comes out faster. Watch how much pressure I'm putting on the center of the book here. In fact, let's put something under there. There we go. I think that's pretty cool. All right, let's put a ring of gold or a ring of silver dots, huh? I think I want to bring a gold drops over the top of that. All right. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring in these dots on the bottom. Since I am right-handed, I'm going left to right. If you were left-handed, I would suggest going whatever direction makes the most sense to you. This keeps my hand out of the liquid pearls. And in fact, I should do top to bottom first. I would highly suggest to give these things time to dry. So I'm not going to go back and I'm not going to touch this until all of these dots have dried. So I want to go in and bring in some gold again up in here. Not gonna do it until these are dry. And I might wanna do another row on the inside. Not gonna do it until the outside is dry. We work from the inside out using this type of material because it has to dry and we do not want to bring our fingers through the product, right? See right there? I could have very easily dropped my finger right in the middle of that, and that would be tragic. You can wipe it off and redo it if you do it soon enough. I might bring that rich gold in right now because I do want to try to finish this up. That might be the wrong thing to do. Okay. So this is not completely dried yet, which is probably a mistake to keep playing with it, but I'm bringing this silver through. And I like the ridge. Oh, see what I just did? What did I just tell you guys not to do? Okay. So, yeah, I did that. Let's just hope I don't do it again. Remember, this is the Pinata Rich Gold from Jacquard. I love using this rich gold in a lot of different ways, including stamping with it. So I like to buy it in the big bottle. You can, of course, buy it in the little bottle. I do like using alcohol ink for this because it really covers well. It's a gorgeous color. And we're just trying to brush it on the tops, which is a little difficult. Trying to be very steady with it. Now I can go back in with my other paints to fix up any of those boo-boos. Or leave them, depending on how they look, you know. I think it adds some interest here. I would suggest to have a brush dedicated to alcohol ink. I did not do that with this brush, and there's a good possibility that this brush won't really be usable for other mediums, definitely not for watercolor. So here's where I can take this and kind of fix up this edge where I messed it up. You see, you can just go back and fix it. It's not like it's huge. It's just frustrating. You know, we don't want to have to repeat work that we've already done too many times. Although we do that pretty often in this type of application or in this type of medium, you know. Actually, with all artwork, I just kind of keep working on it until it's done. Be careful what you're knocking over. All right. I am going to wait now before I touch it anymore. Because here I am trying to do this, and then I just put my finger through another dot. Let them dry. By golly, let them dry. I think I have a little more gold on over here than I do over here. I think I can adjust that with just paint instead of with the alcohol ink. I'm gonna take that out of the water. Oh, don't put water on your book. All right, this time I really am gonna let it dry, I promise. I wanted it to feel like it was a magic book. I think it does that. Right? Okay. All right, we'll chat soon, everybody. Bye.